In the last class, I was discussing the concept of resonance. Is it correct? So that was incompleted in the last class. So once again, we shall continue from resonance. See, what I told you is a single Lewy structure cannot explain the stability of the molecule. Then what will happen is, in order to attain stability with the same position of the nuclei, understand, with the same position of the nuclei or atom, the electrons are going to be delocalized. Delocalized means, understand, someone settles in a place is called localized. Someone is moving means delocalized. And this is with a purpose. The purpose is to attain stability. And to go to minimum energy. And to attain stability. So this concept is called resonance. So we shall write our definition for resonance. You write this. The phenomenon of delocalization of pi bonded electrons and lone pair of electrons. Correct? With the similar or same energy and position of nuclei, with same energy and position of nuclei, and forms resonance hybrid. This is called resonance. Now, some of the informations about resonance I write. Okay? Some of the informations about resonance is this. The position of atoms remains the same in all resonance structures. So you have no rights to move the position of the atoms. Then what you can move? Only the valence electrons you have to move. For example, carbon dioxide has this skeleton. You have no rights to move the position of the atoms. Central atom is carbon, the other two atoms are oxygen. Nitrite ion, double bond O minus, lone pair, here 4 electrons, here 6 electrons. So this skeleton you have no rights to change. But you can move these electrons, 5 electrons and these electrons. That you can move. So that means position of the atoms remains same in the resonance structures. One more thing. The resonance structures are not real structures. For example, what is the structure of a molecule? None of the resonance structures are its real structures. Then which is the real structure? The real structure is what? Resonance hybrid. The real structure is resonance hybrid with the lowest energy. With the lowest energy. So some more points are there. You shall learn this in the organic chemistry. For example, a single charged species is more stable than charge separation, plus minus. A species without charge is more stable than a species with charge. That much detail as a discussion of the annual exam is not required. So some more ideas are there which I have not mentioned here. Now the concept of resonance, you can understand. Try this definition. Example. Write this example. Example 1. Consider ozone. Consider ozone. So what is the formula of ozone? O3. See the resonance structures. Double bond O. So this is already octet. This is also octet, remember. So by the time you are familiar, is it not? Now how to form a bond with another ozone, another oxygen? So this is not in requirement of any more electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you cannot share the electron of this oxygen. That is why form a coordinate bond. I have used both the electrons of this oxygen. Now, this is one of the resonance structures. One of the resonance structure. So, I will write an identical structure. Look here. Since the resonance structures are identical, this type of arrow we are using for writing various resonance structures. Okay. Now you see, these two electrons are going to form a pi bond here, and this is going to become a lone pair. This is another structure. You can number the oxygen. 1, 2, 3. So earlier, 1 and 2 was double bond. Now you see what is happening. 1 and 2 is single bond. Now the pi bond, what is here? Is a lone pair. And in the earlier structure, carbon atom 3 was having 3 lone pair. Now it is having how many?
2.
Only 2 lone pair, and lone pair has become 5. Is it correct? So, now, whether these two are the resonance structures and they are the real structures, they are the resonance structures. They are not the real structures. And these two structures I will call as resonance structures. But what you have written here? None of the resonance structure is the real structure of the molecule. Then what is the real molecule? See this. That is a hybrid. Hybrid of these two. Hybrid of these two means what? So, this bond is neither a single bond, that bond is neither a double bond. That means the double bond character is oscillating between two oxygen atoms. Understand? Double bond character is oscillating. Bond order is 2 here and bond order is 1 here. But in ozone, the bond order is 1.5 for both the bonds. How do I know this? You know, spectroscopical measurement is done. For oxygen, O double bond O, you have written in the last class, is it not? Values. For some other peroxide bond, O single bond O, length is there. But in case of ozone, the bond length is in between a double bond and single bond. It is in between. For example, the data is here. I'll write. See, O single bond O is the length of the O single bond O is 148 picometer. 148 picometer, and the double bond O is 121 picometer. But in case of ozone, it is 128 picometer. Remember. So what is this? This is reality. None of the bonds are single bond or double bond. You understand what I am telling? Double bond length is 121 picometer. Single bond length is 148 picometer. In case of ozone, both the bonds are equal. What is the point? And who says this? Spectroscopical data. By using wavelength of the light, they measure bond length. And it says both the bonds are equal. And how much it is also is said? 128. That means it is in between a double bond and a single bond. And that is why I told you bond order is 1.5. Because how do you measure bond order? 1, 2, 3. Between two atoms. 3 by 2. This is the bond order. So bond order, this is, what is this? Resonance. Resonance hybrid. What is the bond order? Bond order in ozone. Total bonds you calculate. 1, 2, 3. How many? 2. So 1.5 is the bond order. So write this. This is the, which is ozone? This is ozone. Which is really ozone? This is really the structure of ozone. One more I think. One more example I take. Example 2. Look at the board. Nitrite ion. That is NO2 minus. You have already written the Lewis dot structure. A single Lewis dot structure cannot explain the stability. Do you know what is the nitrate ion? Central atom is what? Nitrate. What are the other species? One oxygen and one O minus. Is it correct? So I will write one oxygen here and one O minus here. O minus is in requirement of only one electron, correct? Because O minus is equal to? 7 electrons, correct? 7 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, I will form a bond now. So, 1 electron is in the bond. Then, nitrogen has how many electrons? 5 electrons. So, here I will form a double bond. Now, how many electrons here? 4. So, this nitrogen is octet, correct now? Totally forgotten in the last class, whatever is taught, is it not? This nitrogen is, this oxygen is octet now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now show the electron of nitrogen. Give the account of all the electron of nitrogen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whether nitrogen is octet? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Is this the structure of nitrite ion? No. No. This is not the structure of nitrite ion. What is the resonance structure of nitrite ion? These two lone pair forms a double bond here, and that is why this is going to form a O minus. Then what to write? N O minus double bond O. How many electrons are remaining now? 4, these two as it is. How many electrons are formed now? 6. Huh? Okay, then which is the, these are the resonance structures. Now which is the real nitrite ion? The resonance hybrid. That means this bond is neither a double bond and this bond is neither a single bond. Then what is the structure? N O O. So like similar bond order 1, 2, 3 divided by 2. So this is delta minus nitrite and this is resonance hybrid. One more structure I will write. Okay, shall I write the carbon dioxide molecule? 3. Carbon dioxide. What is the structure of carbon dioxide? C. Double bond O. Double bond O. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And carbon S? No one pet electron. Is this correct? Now look here. What is the resonance structure of this? Huh? Look here. You form a triple bond and this is equal to form a lone. Huh? So what to write now? C triple bond O plus. Why plus? Because these two electrons belong to this oxygen. Now it is coming for one oxygen and one carbon. So this oxygen has lost one electron. But that was the plus. Here the electron is available. Here only is available. One oxygen is one carbon. One electron is lost. Here is single bond and this is O minus. Why? Because this oxygen has gained how many? Here electron error. One carbon and one oxygen. Carbon tag the equator, other than six to carbon extra will walk. So it has got one electron extra from the carbon. Then what about carbon? ಇಕಡೆ ಒಂದು ಬಂತು ಆ ಕಡೆ ಒಂದು ಹೋಯ್ತು ನೋ ಚೇಂಜ್. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಈ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಹಿಂಗಾಯ್ತು. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್? ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಟೂ ರೆಸೋನೆನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೆಸೋನೆನ್ಸ್ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್? ಸೊ ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಬಾಂಡ್, ಒಂದು ಟ್ರಿಪಲ್ ಇದೆ, ಒಂದು ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಇದೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಡಬಲ್ ಇದೆ. Then what is the resonance hybrid? Partially double bond, partially triple bond. O, this is partially C, this is partially triple bond. O. Now here it is delta minus delta minus. Resonance hybrid. One more structure I will write. This you are not it, is it not? One more structure I will write. Carbonate ion. Carbonate ion. What is the formula? CO3 2 minus. Okay. How many carbon are there and how many oxygen are there? One carbon, central atom. Next up? Three oxygen is not there. One oxygen and two O minus. Try to understand. One oxygen and two O minus. So let me write the structure now. Look at the board. C. Double bond O. Single bond O minus. Single bond O minus. 1, 2, 3, 4. Correct? How many electron here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many here?
6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many here?
4.
1, 2. All are octet. Correct? Now you are thinking that these two bonds are single bonds and this bond is a double bond. But spectroscopy says all the three bonds are equal. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ರೆಸೋನೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ವಾ? ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಹೇಳಿ, ಹೇಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ನೋಡಿ? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಹೇಳಿ, ಈಗ ಇದನ್ನ ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ, ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇದೇನಾಯ್ತು? ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ನೋ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ಗೂ ಪ್ರಯಾರಿಟಿ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ O minus as it is. Correct? Single bond. How many? 6. Double bond. How many? 4. Next one. Next one. This is a double bond. This is a double bond. Now which is not a double bond? This one is not a double bond. So, form a double bond so that this becomes a single bond. What is the structure? C. Double bond O. Next up. Single bond O minus 6. And this is? Sorry, O minus. Correct? O minus. Single bond O minus 6. Now which is the carbonate atom? None of them are carbonate atom. That is why they are what? They are resonance structures. Then which is the correct carbonate atom? Because I told you, this is not a double bond. All the three bonds are equal. Bond length is same. So what do? C, O, O, O. Delta minus. Delta minus, delta minus. And this is resonance ion. What is the bond order? Tell me. Bond order ready to know what is the bond count body divided by number of atoms body. Well, do that till 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 by 3. 1.33. This is the bond order. 1.33. Now some examples I give and you try this. See, I have given some examples here. I have given some examples here. You try these examples. Write the skeletal structure and write the resonance structures of these examples. I think this may be not that easy, but try something. And if any doubts arises, you can ask me. So this is about resonance. And with this, I will conclude the concept of resonance. Okay. Now let us start with one more. Write this heading: polarity of the bonds. Polarity of the bonds. See, non-polar molecules. Polar molecules. These are the two types of molecules. And accordingly, bonds are also like that. Non-polar covalent bond, polar covalent bond. Okay? That is polarity of the bonds. Non-polar molecules. What do you mean by pole? A charge. What do you mean by a dipole? A molecule, HCl is a dipole. Because H has a delta plus charge, this has a delta minus charge. Understand? So this is a dipole. And this is the polarity of H plus and the hydrogen, and that is the polarity of. And this is a dipole and this molecule is a polar molecule. Now take hydrogen molecule, HH. Take hydrogen molecule, HH. There is no plus minus. There is no plus minus. And that is why it is non-polar molecule. And this bond is a non-polar covalent bond. This is a polar covalent bond. This is a non-polar covalent bond. Now tell me, I will write one example. ClCl. Whether this is a polar or non-polar covalent. Non-polar. Okay. Then listen to me. A covalent bond between two atoms of equal electronegativity. Okay. Equal electronegativity is called non-polar covalent bond, and such molecules are called non-polar molecules. Shall I write the definition? What to write? A covalent bond between two atoms of equal electronegativities. Is called non-polar covalent bond. Such molecules having what? Non-polar covalent bond. Are called what to write? Non-polar molecules. Okay, some examples I will give you. Hydrogen, chlorine, oxygen, nitrogen. Now you will surprise, carbon dioxide also. Methane also, this I will explain in the next class, simply write now. These are some of the non-polar molecules. Next, what is polar molecule? Polar molecules and polar covalent bond. A covalent bond between two atoms of what? Unequal electronegativities is called what? Polar covalent bond. And molecules having polar covalent bonds are called what? Are called polar molecules. Example. What are the example? HCl, HF, H2O. H2O in the sense what? OHH. See, this is delta minus. This is delta plus. This is delta plus. NH3, SO2, sulfur dioxide. Because these elements are having different electronegativities, and these are all what type of covalent bond? For example, this is delta plus, delta minus. This is a dipole. These are all dipoles. So such molecules are called polar molecules. And polar molecules are having polar covalent bonds. Non-polar molecules are having non-polar covalent bonds. Let us. So based on the polarity of the bonds, one more point we have to discuss, and that is dipole moment. One very very important term. What? Dipole moment. Dipole moment. And dipole moment is denoted with a symbol mu. What is the dipole? I have told you, is it not? Yes or no? What is the dipole? This is a dipole because there is a charge separation. What is the dipole? This is one dipole. There are two poles. It is a dipole. Which is not a dipole? Hydrogen is not a dipole because it is non-polar molecules. Okay? Then what is dipole moment? So this is a vector quantity. Have you learnt vector in physics? So this is a vector quantity. That is why carbon dioxide and methane have dipole moment zero. They are vector products. The dipole moment of the bonds got cancelled. I'll come to that little later. So definition of dipole moment is mathematically, I'll write first. Mu is equal to E into D. Definition I'll write afterwards. E into D. What is E? E, electric charge in coulombs. The assigned unit of charge is what? Coulombs. And what is D? Distance between two poles. And this you can call as a bond length only. This is nothing but bond length. Distance between the two poles, centers. Now, what about E? For example, delta plus same as delta minus. This is positive charge, same as delta, that is negative charge. And HF is different from HCl. So E is different. And even distance is also different, yes or no? Chlorine is a bigger atom. So dipole moment depends on what? Charge and distance between the two poles. Now what is the SI unit, can you tell me? SI unit of dipole moment, can you tell me? Correct. Coulomb into meter, or capital C, small f. But this is so small, negligible small, Coulomb is becoming very very high. That is why the unit of dipole moment is what? D bar. Okay, normally we don't use the word what? Capital letter. D bar. What is D bar? D E B Y E. What is D bar? Energy joule. Correct? Length meter. Like the dipole moment? D bar. And you know, assignment telling 1 D bar 3.336 into 10 raised to minus 30 coulomb into meter. Just imagine. So small. How much? 10 raised to minus 30. And this unit is used to measure dipole moment. Can you write in wordings what is dipole moment? The product of, come on, the product of electric charge and distance between two poles in a polar molecule is called what? Dipole moment. Okay? Now, my question is, what about the dipole moment in the H2 molecule? H2 molecule, hydrogen molecule, what about the dipole moment? I will write the bond also, HH. Come on, tell me, what is the dipole moment? So mathematically I have given you the values. Tell me. Mu is equal to 0. Why 0? Whether D 0 or E 0? E is 0. Because there is no charge. Because it is a non-polar molecule. Because the covalent bond is non-polar bond. There is no charge separation. E is 0. Distance is 0. definitely not zero. Bond length is there. What about the dipole moment of example 1? Example 2. What about the dipole moment of Cl2 molecule? Mu equal to 0. So, it means note for non-polar molecules, for non-polar molecules, dipole moment mu equal to 0. Cl2 0, H2 0, N2 0, O2 0. Correct? No. Then why CO2 0? Carbon dioxide molecule. Why this is zero? This is somewhat more important. Now, before I go to the dipole moment of CO2, one small thing you must note. Notation of dipole moment, I'll tell you. Look at this. Notation. You can write on upwards. Look at this. HCl, what is the charge separation? This is delta plus, this is delta minus. See the notation, right? Notation. Yes, this is the notation. The arrow, half-headed arrow with a tail like this, crossed. This is towards electronegative atom, electron movement. And this is towards electron positive atom. Okay? Now, let me explain the dipole moment of CO2 molecule. See, carbon dioxide has this structure. Double bond O, double bond O. And this bond angle is 180 degree. Understood? The bond angle in water is 104.5 degree. That is not linear. And this molecule is linear. Linear is 180 degree really. Pole ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೇನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಅಂತ. ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಮೋರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಯಾರು ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಡೈಪೋಲ್ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ನಾನು? ಯಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೆಂಗ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ನಾನು? ಯಸ್. ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾ? ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಈಗ ನನ್ನ ಈ ತರ 180 ಡಿಗ್ರಿಗೆ ಪುಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ cancels. Carbon monoxide zero na? Whether carbon monoxide is zero? This is not zero. Because carbon is less electronegative. Oxygen is more electronegative. But carbon dioxide is what? Zero. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಹೇಳಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ? ಏನ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕು? ದ ಡೈಪೋಲ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್, ಅದೇ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ. ಅಂದ್ರೇನು? ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಬಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್. ಹಾಗೆ 120 ಕೂಡ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ? ಈಗ ಇದು ಒಂದ್ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ವಾ? ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಒಬ್ರಿ ಮೂರ್ ಹಗ್ಗ ಕಟ್ಟೋಣ 120. ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಒಂದು ಫುಲ್ ಇವ್. ವೆರಿ ಗೋಸ್ ನೋ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ಡೈಪೋಲ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಸಿಒ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ವಾಟ್ magnitude and opposite direction are cancelled. therefore resultant dipole moment as diagram itself resultant dipole moment in CO2 is zero. So like this you have to explain dipole moment. Some more examples I will consider in the next class. Thank you.